stop filling in time for you guys. Alright guys, are you guys ready for the Overwatch voice actor? Alright. Introducing first, he is the voice of Roadhog. He's on Twitch TV as Optimus Slime, and you can hear his voice, of course, over at Universal Studios as well. Please welcome Josh Peterson!
Ready to go. Oh, all
right. Introducing next, Roadhog's best friend, who I hear has quite the explosive personality. Give it up for Chris Parson!
SacAnime. I'm SacAnime. It's good to see you. Just keep it low key. Low key, I'll tell you, I'm with some voice stuff.
Hello, this is SacAnime. SacAnime is incredible. Everybody does it. In fact, if you want to audition for a real job and want to see you walking first, if they like that, you go to the next round.
Introducing next, he's done some great stuff for, he's also been the voice of Raphael in Diablo. For you Hanzo mates, one half of the Shimano Bros, Paul Nakauchi! Introducing next, this man is a good friend of mine too, and he's also a representative of the SF Shock Team, right? He's got a great comedy sketch called The Golden Hour, and you gotta check it out. Please give it up for everyone's favorite omnic, Feodor. Give it up for Torbjorn's voice actor, Keith Silverstein! Voice actor, Elise. And last, not the least, of course, we have everyone's favorite gorilla. The voice of Winston. Crispin!
And then there's, you know, what they do for the game, they're not the same person. It's like, you know, but you know, like Josh is definitely, his person is the same as who he does. That's just him.
He's a lot less scary in real life.
But you know, same as for Keith.
And I'm a gorilla.
From the moon. That Crispin does the best twist dance ever for those of you who saw the audience. Yeah. All the angles. It's a lot of twisting.
Don't dare, I have to leave to catch a flight. But I just got a message from Sombra, Carolina, and the reason that I'm running home is because she's coming to visit us in LA, and she wanted to tell you all that she's sorry she couldn't make it, but she will make it up to NorCal, and she will come see all of you. And Leila Cafe, she's going to visit you.
Optimus Prime.
This man's been with me for 30 years. He hasn't let me down yet. I don't think he ever will.
I think I'm very proud of the trailer for Hanzo, the Hanzo trailer. That was one of those things when I first recorded it, I had really no idea that it would look the way it did, or, you know, because you go into the studio and you just handed a bunch of lines and they say, okay, you know, do, you know, this line, give us three takes. And so you just do it for, you know, the entire thing. And when they put it together, I was like, oh my God, was that me? I was really surprised at just the way that they had, you know, synced everything and made it all, you know, and so, I think I'm very proud about that particular trailer.
You know, I don't know that there's any one specific performance that I can really point to, but I think it's just, because I've done a lot of video games, I think we all have, and just being able to be a part of a game like this that is just so, has such a positive, you know, has such a positive effect on people, and so many people, and that's something I'll be proud of for the rest of my life.
Yeah, you know, it's always hard to pick. I mean, I critique myself a lot, so it's not like I can look at any performance I've done and go like, that was perfect or whatever. But there are ones that I'm proud of. I mean, Torbjorn is definitely one of the characters I'm most proud of. Izuka from Hunter x Hunter, I have so much fun. I'm very proud of the work I've done on that. And a couple of films, One Piece film Gold. I played the villain in that, and I'm proud of that, and I'm a huge fan of Lupin the Third, and the film Jigen's Breakstone, I got the voice of Lupin the Third, and I'm very proud of that too. So there's a couple things that just made me extra happy to work on.
Yeah.
I think May will be my favorite character for all my life. I think that's not a good thing for a voice actor, but that's the truth. It's my first time to do a character in English, especially in that short movie called Rise and Shine. Oh, I really, really love that one.
For the longest time, the character of Sume in Wolf's Rain was probably the nearest and dearest to my heart. As some of you may know, I'm a mythology scholar, and the mythological background of Wolf's Rain is pretty amazing. But I have to say, there is no show. I usually pride myself on being incredibly professional, and I can come in the booth and knock out my performance and do my thing, no problem. Nothing gets to me. Overwatch gets to me. There are times when I walk in the booth, and when we were recording Recall, Winston's short, and they had Tracer's line already recorded, and she comes over the phone line and says, "Winston, is that you, love?" And I literally got choked up. Like, I had to be like, "Can we have a minute?" Is on the webcam, and his passionate speech about, you know, the world needs us now more than ever, and then, "Are you with me?" And I'm like, okay, yeah, sure, but wait, I did that. That's my point. Okay, yeah, cool. I mean, let's play. Thank you all.
For Key Silverstein and Crispin Freeman, for each of you, what's the one thing that your mother would like for us to know about you? What's the one thing that your mother would like for us to know about you?
If my mother would like for everybody to know about me.
Oh yeah, one thing.
You are asking what my mother would like the audience to know about me?
Okay. Ask that to plenty of the voice actors for answers.
Like an endearing quality, like mom saying, "You know, my son is so small."
Oh my God, it's like the Jewish mother I never had.
I
had a Jewish mom that was on the wrong side.
I'm a big fan of Junkrat.
Yeah. So, I have two. When the first cinematic trailer came out, the only other trailer was the gameplay trailer, where you could actually see the game. And I was watching it, and the music is awesome, the character's awesome. I was like, wow, this is really great. And then Zenyatta came around the corner and said, true self is without form. And I was like, sold! I was like, Shiva Robot, sold! I am totally But the other one that slayed me, because it was one of the first videos that they got came out, was Soldier 76. Yeah. When I heard, I didn't even recognize Fred Tatasciore as Soldier 76, because I'm so used to hearing him as the Hulk and all these sort of big creature voices. And to hear him use his natural voice, and you know, we're all soldiers now. And I'm like, oh my God. And I had to go up and I was like, Fred, you're amazing. So yeah, I think it's a toss up between 76 and Zenyatta.
I like to be Hanzo because it just taught me how to say his outer voice line in Japanese.
Let's hear it. Okay, come on.
Yugawa.
Roadhog and Junkrat's ride of a lifetime.
The ride to mayhem.
But it would be like a 3D show, right? Too violent.
You can't really shoot rockets at you in the ride. It's just special. Put the goggles on.
It's like a ride of 3D IMAX explosions.
Experience zero G on Winston's lower body.
Like Zenyatta's infinity roller coaster. Which is like,
just
doesn't stop. Polonius trip, yes.
A dragon world. Let's ride hard.
Is that big hammer that just goes back?
Personally, had to pick someone to take their place. Who would it be?
Well, that's a good one.
That is such a bizarre scenario.
Yeah.
Like, we're going to step down and say, like, who is it? And you're actually asking us, who should we get to replace?
You're out of here, but who should we get to take your place?
Why don't we make a pact? If all of us have to step down, we recommend each other.
Yeah!
Zenyatta would be us.
Your chin is Roadhog. Ready to go.
Hold on.
Experience first.
I think I'd like Elise to play my part.
That's what I want to hear.
I don't want Bhimani.
I think you're in trouble.
What's our favorite thing about the character we voice in Overwatch?
I like that Torbjorn's on kind of a second lease in life. In his history, he invented some things that he decided later he wasn't so proud of the way they were being used. And I like that his new lease on life is to kind of fix the mistakes he made earlier. And I kind of like that. I like that he's on a little bit of a do-over.
I think I identify with Winston because there's this idea that he was looking at the Earth from above, and there were these human ideals that he found noble, principles he wanted to live by. And then when he finally landed on Earth, he looked around and realized nobody was following them. And I think that just doesn't compute to him. And I sort of understand that. There are times when I feel like an elf pole, you know, planted on the moon, looking at the Earth going, why
can't we do this? Why not?
You know, and so there's sort of this indefatigable optimism and idealism to Winston that I really identify with. I mean, it's interesting. If someone had given me a chart of all the Overwatch characters and asked me to pick one, I would have picked Winston to play, and I just got cast for him blind. Like, I had no idea what I was getting into. So I feel very fortunate that I got put in exactly the place I wanted to be.
I'm just gonna... That's
Is that because of modeled after Paul and I'm
with Yes.
Or when I get to go nuts is what I like about it.
I love the fact that they kind of went deeper into Roadhog's backstory with the comic, and how they kind of explain that he's something really bad happened to him. Like something horrible. That he was like, forget this, and leaves Junkertown and goes to live by himself. And he has that really cool line in the comic, it's like, the world deserves us. So he's almost the nemesis to Winston, because Winston is the he's the non-pessimist, the opportunist, the optimist. Whereas Roadhog is real cynical, you know, real like, yeah, whatever. And I think it's really cool that they had him do that. So that's the thing I really like about the character, and I'm excited to find out.
Yeah. And I like that Zenyatta is just so zen-like and peaceful that it really, whenever I go into sessions, it actually relaxes me. It's a good thing, so I enjoy that.
I'm asleep right now, actually.
Not even here, because it's an astral projection.
You're beautiful!
Nor she's as strong as Zarya, but she's a scientist, but she is a hero, and that's special for me, because I studied chemical technology in college, so that's perfect for me.
There's this character, Hammond, they keep talking about, who I guess got as smart as Winston as well, because they've got the same color code on the screen. It's all sort of hinted at in the backgrounds of the base. And I'm like, who is this Hammond character? I want to find out what he's all about and what his relationship to Winston is. So I want to see what happens with these two.
Yeah. We said this the other day, like, the childhood. With Junkrat and Roadhog.
Growing up together, throwing rocks at each other, skinning his knee, and I put the band-aid on.
That should be its own movie.
Yeah, maybe some exploration of Hanzo and Genji as, you know, young Hanzo and Genji before, you know.
Attempted murder.
Yeah, we call that one of our savagely
songs, actually, and it turned into a sort of a cyborg thing.
A cyborg, who's always profusely requiring healing.
we call that Sasuke and Itachi. Sorry, Naruto joke.
I want to know something.
romantic for me. You know, she was frozen for 10 years, so what happened to her boyfriend?
Wait, she had a boyfriend?
Oh,
maybe. I just want to know more about Torb's past, maybe his relationship with Reinhardt and you know, the whole just beginnings of Overwatch. I mean, there's so many things. There's so much we have addressed. There's so much I don't know about my character. I assume all the characters have a ton more of their past that we can learn about them and other side characters that have been hinted at. And I have apparently a large number of family members we don't know that much about. So I'm always teased very much when I see a new short or something and it hints at anything in my character's past or any of the characters' past. But, you know, mine specifically, because I'm like, oh, because like, you want to know more and incorporate that. Or, that.
Yeah, definitely. Just anything more to find out. I'm definitely interested.
Thank you very much.
Thank you, guys.
Hi, everyone. I was just curious if you guys, aside from voice acting, if you guys had any special secret talents that you wanted to share.
Show us now.
If you want.
Okay, here we go. Josh, I might get juggle and break dance, but not at the same time.
Juggle and break dance.
Let me see. So I used to train in kung fu, especially weapons, specialized in weapons, and I actually used to teach archery. So I'm sort of a closet archery. I'm not quite Japanese in this way.
Oh, wow.
Being a marksman.
Yeah.
I work just for fun.
I'm a really good swimmer.
You just took my, I was all city in high school too. I was a 100 butterfly.
I was an athlete once upon a time.
Yeah. Well, what did you swim?
I swam the 50 yard free was my event. Swam in 21
sprinters.
Seconds. That was my best
time. Wow.
Yeah, it was pretty good. So, absolutely. That was fun, but I stayed getting in the pool at 5 in the morning and going to school. It's like, I swam too in like, in like the 90s when like there was no Michael Phelps and like swimming pod, like it wasn't cool, you know? But
you'd have to wear those Speedos at 6 in the morning.
6 in the morning Speedo is not good. It was an awkward time to like wear a Speedo in high school.
Did you shave your entire body?
I did. And then I had some jerk coach who was like, you know, if you pour hydrogen peroxide on it right after, it'll help you slowly. This got really bad.
I'm pretty naturally hairless, so I didn't have to.
As you can tell, I am a very hairy man. But yeah, swimming. Somebody good talents? Good. Thank you.
Thank you, guys.
This is a great hitchhiker film. Actually, I used to use it hitchhiking years ago when people actually hitchhiked. Yes, there you go.
Watch a Peewee's movie, Mickey.
And they go, let's stop with that poor man with the broken thumb.
What new country map would you want to see?
What new map would you want to see?
A country.
Country.
I'd love to see something like in the Swiss Alps. That would be sort of fun.
Anything else?
Shanghai, maybe.
Yeah.
Metropolis?
Burbank.
How about Bakersfield? Bakersfield.
Thank you.
That's it for the end of Q&A. Please remain seated. We're going to be taking a photo and a short break. So do you guys have anything that you want to say to your guys' fans?
Thank you. From the bottom of all of our hearts, Overwatch is a world worth fighting for. Represents everyone equally. It's a diverse game that we can all be proud of. Men and women kicking butt at the same level, taking names and working as a team. I think that's really important. And I'll say what Paul said again, you know, there's too much us and them. Right now it's just us. So thank you guys for being here, for being part of this with my heart, especially. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
I've been a voice actor for about 14 years and been able to make a living at it for like the last 12. I've never seen anything like this game, ever. Not as a little kid, nothing. So it's just incredibly moving to see how dedicated you guys are to the world of it, to knowing about it, talking about it, and making the costumes from the world. Just the sort of creation that Overwatch inspires, just to sum it up quickly, is really what moves me. I didn't think that, you know, people could be so inspired by a game like this, but I was wrong. So, thank you.
I think everybody on this panel knows the fact that realizes that, you know, when we're actually just doing the work, it's very solitary. Just in the booth by ourselves, and you know, we have just the, you know, the director and the, you know, the design guy, and so it can be just very sort of isolating, you know, doing voiceover work. But coming here and meeting all of you, it's just like this whole world. It's like has opened up, and you know, this tiny little black and white space you're in has become this huge, like, color screen of all of you wonderful people out there. Faces and just the enthusiasm that you bring to meeting and coming to meet us is really what has just been so moving and amazing, that to meet all of you, you know, how creative you are, the gifts and the artwork that you create, you know, from this game. And I just want to really say how much it truly has changed me, and I thank you for your participation and for your love of all that is Overwatch. So thank you to you.
Just any time you are stuck in traffic, or you're feeling stressed, or you got a deadline you gotta meet, just take a moment, breathe, and experience tranquility. Thank you.
Yeah, just to echo a little bit of what's been said. I mean, it's true, we work very isolated, and whether we're working on dubbing or a game or original series or whatever it is, it's so weird because it's its own thing. We don't get any instant gratification. If we're working with our peers, maybe like, hey, good job, you know, we are, but a lot of stuff is not. We don't work with other actors at the same time. But when those things go out into the world, and then it's months, sometimes years later, and we start to see a reaction from fans, from people, from friends, from those around us, it can be jarring in a very positive way. And then when you have something as big as this, which I don't think anybody predicted, I mean, Blizzard always puts out great games, but I can't imagine that they really thought this was gonna be this big. It's really, like I said, jarring in a really good way. Like, it's amazing. I sometimes have to, like, you know, kind of pinch myself and shake my head. Like, it's so bizarre, but so wonderful to have been a part of this and be accepted by so many. Like, you guys come and you greet us and you say hi, and some of you bring gifts and you do drawings, and even the things we see online, where we just see all the artwork that you guys do, where the cosplays that are made, and it's amazing. It's so amazing to be a part of that. Like, it's unbelievable. So I mean, I hope you really understand, like, when we stop and think about it, it chokes us up. It chokes me up to stop and, like, really legitimately think about how wonderful it is. And so I just want to say thank you, because it's such a warm, wonderful feeling to be a part of this, a wonderful, positive community of Overwatch. So thank you, thank you, thank you.
It is my belief that we become the stories we tell ourselves. The stories we hold near and dear to our hearts are the ones that inform us. And we have a choice. We have a choice whether we're going to choose stories that are pessimistic and downtrodden, or whether we're going to choose stories that are optimistic, uplifting, and strive for different ideals. And then the first time I saw the Overwatch trailer, I got so choked up I could not see the screen. And I thought, am I really a part of this? Is this what I stumbled into this, and now we're making this story that has the breadth of diversity and optimism that I had never seen in my 20 years of voice acting. I had never seen anything like this. And it is so heartening to have all of you here, because it shows that you like it too. And if we can all strive for an ideal like that, if we can all sort of reach for the angels of our better nature, maybe we have a chance, you know? Maybe there's a future for all of us. Because it's too easy. It's so easy to be too cool for school, to be sort of flippant and dismissive. It makes you vulnerable to be sincere, to actually care about something. And you know what? I care about this. And I feel honored that I am now in this position where I get to be part of a team. It's not just us, it's the writers and the creators of Blizzard. They're the ones who create this world and write it. We help them manifest it. But we're all working to put on a show that all of you seem so inspired by. And the size of this audience gives me hope, right? That makes me go, okay, so we're not crazy. People actually want things to be better. You know, people want there to be more inclusion. People want there to be more love and caring in the world. So thank you. Thank you for listening to the better angels of your nature. Thank you for playing this fun game. It's a fun game, but I don't know any game that has this kind of story, that has this kind of meaning behind it. So I embrace the meaning. I feel blessed to be able to share that meaning with all of you, and I'm so glad that all of you appreciate it. Thank you.
Yes! Thank you guys for coming out here. Please remain seated a little bit. Are you taking a photo? You don't have to go home yet? No, so we
thank you, SacAnime!